get ready to match the stars. Joe Silver, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Esther Rowe, Richard Dawson, Fanny Flagg, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now, here's the star, Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Byrne, and thank you, friends, and thank you. Are you all ready?
Yeah.
I welcome you, Joe, Brett, Charles, Esther, Richard, and Fanny.
Thank you.
Let's say hello to our current champ, Laura Callahan. You've won one game, right? And you won the $250 part of the audience match, and that means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. Are you ready for that?
Yes, I am.
All right, we'll have a go at it in 1 minute and 14 seconds, right after this. Here we are with Laura, who is not just a face in the passing night. She's going to have a go at the big money now. Ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Now, in order to collect the $2,500, you've got to match one of our celebrities exactly head-to-head. Which one will it be?
I'll have to take Richard.
Okay.
Of course. Right, the last time we played, I gave you snowshoes.
All right. This is it. Worth $2,500, and it goes like this. Blank. Beam. B-E-A-M. Blank. Beam. Now he's finished, Laura. What answer would you suggest would match his in this case? Blank beam.
Laser beam.
Laser beam. Eight people applauded.
Nine.
I beg your pardon. Nine people applauded. Laser beam. Richard, she says that'll match you for $2,500.
There's wooden beam and sun beam. Of course, in New York, there's Abe.
Abe beam, right?
I said moon beam.
Moon beam.
You look like a romantic soul.
Yes, moon beam.
Happily
is
married, I thought you...
Delightful answer, yes. Laser beam ain't bad. You have a very scientific bent, don't you?
I was just lost.
You were all.
Well, it is a good answer.
It is good.
But it's just sort of I would have thought of a man would have said that.
Yes, and she's not a man.
If you are,
I've
been going out with lizards.
She is not a man. Now, Laura, you're still a champ, and you've still got your 350, and you're going to meet another player right now, so let's welcome Kim Ackles.
Right.
Kim, you know Laura?
Hi, Laura.
All right. Where are you from, Kim?
Hollywood.
And, oh, right, Hollywood. The screwy down in Hollywood. What else about Kim?
I'm a theater arts student at UCLA.
Yeah.
Graduating in June, and I don't know what I'm going to do after that. And right now, I'm a nervous wreck.
Are you nervous?
Yes.
Well, you're in show business.
I
you shouldn't
know,
be nervous.
I know. I'm still nervous.
Oh, no, you're
oh,
not.
Yes.
Let me feel your hand there. No, you're not nervous at all. Your hands aren't trembling, and they're not... Whoops, there it is. Now, Kim, it's your choice, A or B.
A, please.
Here we go. William said, when I lost my job, I took one of those discount cross-country buses to go look for work. Times must really be bad. Blank was sitting next to me.
What is that again?
A deathly silence greeted me after I read that question.
Go ahead.
Well, I think it's a marvelous question. Has some terrific possibilities. William said.
William said.
William. It could be Jack, Paul, anybody.
All right.
William said, when I lost my job, I took one of those discount cross-country buses to go look for work. Times must really be bad. Because blank was sitting next to me.
Honey, I just want to cry when I hear those stories.
Yes.
It just makes, but I have a perfect answer.
Not the question was so good, your reading was good.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Yes. Do I get the part?
No, that's but I have to give me an answer while you're standing. Okay.
Oh, this is a marvelous question. Let me just peek at a marvelous answer here for the heck of it and see what we got. Terrific! Well, you see hers. Whoops. Tripped on that cable.
Takes a little time to get used to those.
I thought we were going to tape this thing down so I wouldn't keep falling over it, fellas. Okay, ready, everybody? Charles.
Well, wait a minute.
Charles, you're still thinking. You haven't even started to write.
But he has to take his nap first.
I shall beat you about the head and shoulders with a large stick.
He likes that.
Oh, he likes that. Oh.
That's funny, Dick.
Did you say a stick?
Yes.
Oh, shoot. I don't like to do this.
Oh, I would think you wouldn't.
Put that in there. It's a good one.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. Kim. Have you been thinking while we've been over there treading water?
Sort of.
William said, when I lost my job, I took one of those discount cross-country buses to go look for work. And times must really be bad. Blank was sitting next to me.
A cow? I...
What? Well, Kim,
yeah.
You really want to go to show business, right?
You're going to quit now, right?
Yes. All right. You know, a little typing in shorthand, it wouldn't be a bad idea just to cover yourself there. She said a cow was sitting next to me.
That
yes.
was an interesting trip, huh?
Right, yes.
Utter delight.
Right.
Okay.
Oh. You get out of show business, too.
Well, I'm new here. All right. Yeah, I had President Ford sitting next to me.
President Ford. Yes. All right. What do you have?
I had another old person sitting next to you, and I had Nixon sitting next to
you. Nixon! You got the hang of the game now, Kim?
I think I
did. Okay. Yeah. Charles?
Well, what I was thinking of, I also wrote Nixon, which I think is terrible. But I was also thinking of Max Stevens.
Max Stevens? Who's he?
He owns a scuba place. See, unemployment is high among scuba things because of the frightening effect of the picture Jaws. Most people don't go anymore into rubber suit.
You better get out of show business, too.
It's better than cow.
No, sorry, no. We're going to tie him up there now.
Don't you love
it? Yes, it is. Esther, give us an answer.
Well, I went along with Nixon.
Okay. William said, when I lost my job, it took one of those discount cross-country buses to go look for work, and times must really be bad because blank was sitting next to me.
Nelson Rockefeller.
That's all right. And Fanny.
Honey, I started to write cow. But instead, I wrote a Republican.
A Republican. Okay. Now, Kim, you saw some good answers and some mediocre ones, but I think you got the hang of it now, and we'll see how you do with yours in a moment or so. But right now, we want you to pay attention to this. First round question for Laura. Criminals laugh at Officer O'Hara because instead of beating them with a rubber hose, O'Hara beats them with a rubber blank.
Officer O'Hara?
Officer O'Hara. Criminals laugh at Officer O'Hara.
Quick as a flash.
Good girl.
Well, sure.
My good boy.
That's easy for you
You're
to say.
You're a good boy.
Yes, you are, Dickie. We're
Let
the
me
best
Let see what
one.
You do there. Hmm. Very interesting.
You want to steal any ideas, Doug?
No. You finished, right?
I'm all fair. Right? Fanny,
you got
to
learn,
what's wrong with you today?
Right? Or
what did I do wrong?
There. You ready for us? Criminals laugh at Officer O'Hara because instead of beating them with a rubber hose, O'Hara beats them with a rubber...
ducky.
A rubber ducky.
Oh.
Rubber duck.
Oh, that's a very interesting young lady there, Laura.
It is. Yeah. Rubber duck.
Yeah. Well, no, but not in my block.
No?
No, on my block, O'Hara beats you with a rubber club.
With a rubber club?
Yes, he does.
Okay, Brett.
Boo-boo yourself.
Mr. O'Hara's first name was Mary, and he beat them with a little rubber band like
A rubber
that.
Band. And they loved
it. Oh, there's no boo-boo now, right?
Yes. Charles?
In keeping with the trend, I said cow. No. I said band.
Rubber band. A rubber cow. Criminals laugh at Officer O'Hara because instead of beating him with a rubber hose, O'Hara beats him with a rubber duck, according to Laura.
I wasn't very imaginative. Stick.
A rubber stick, eh?
Well, comments.
No, yeah, well. Okay, I shall refrain from saying it was a rotten answer. Richard. She's looking for a rubber ducky.
Yes, I want a little star, because look how neat I wrote. I wrote neat, and you can read it.
Yeah. That's two for you. Round two coming up. Are you ready for round two, Kim?
Yes.
A or B?
I think I'll go with B this time.
B, all right.
Better luck here.
Chain Gang Charlie said, he said, I got tired of dragging that big iron ball behind me, so to make things easier, I put blank on my ball. Come on, now don't look at me so incredulously. There.
Wait, I think I have it.
I put blank.
Yes, blank.
Just feel free to copy, dear.
I got tired. Oh, you.
That's what I thought.
I got tired of dragging that big iron ball behind me, so to make things easier, I put blank on my ball.
Thank you. We'll call you. Oh. Don't call us.
Okay.
Okay. I don't know why they do that to you, Gene. You try to be helpful.
That's right.
Yes.
Hey, look at me so...
Oh, well, you know where
they're. That's right, Esther and Richard are. Okay. Yes. All right, Fanny, put in the slot. Now, Kim, Chain Gang Charlie said, Charles, put that in that slot there.
I'm trying to make it a provocative, charming game.
Chain Gang Charlie said, I got tired of dragging that big iron ball behind me, so to make things easier, I put blank on my ball.
Wheels?
Wheels. Wheels would
now
work.
That's, yes, it would. That's a very interesting notion.
Anything else would work, Joe?
Well, yes, but wheels is really what you want on it.
Wheels. Yep. One for Kim. Yep. Right.
Now that she's got her act together, I've gone to pieces.
You have. Sorry about that.
I said you put a little grease on it.
Grease.
So it slipped along.
So make it a slick, okay. Charles?
Thank you, sweetheart.
Grease too, I'm sorry.
All right, so that's one pair of wheels and a little grease. Esther?
I oiled them too.
You oiled them. So, there it is, Richard. She says, I have got tired of dragging that big iron ball behind me, so to make things easier, I put wheels on my ball.
I said,
wheels. Okay, another pair of wheels. And Fanny.
Yes, I just love K-Star's voice. Why don't you? K-Star had the
K-Star.
Big hit, Wheel of Fortune.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Wheel of Fortune. So that's three for you. Now, Laurel, one to tie, two to win. Ready? The football coach said,
he said, I don't think my team is all that interested in football. In the middle of the huddle, they were passing around a blank.
You're not going to play. Richard and Dawson, do not play. You play.
Once again.
Football coach said, I don't think my team is all that interested in football. Why, in the middle of the huddle, they were passing around a blank.
A blank.
A blank.
In the middle of the huddle. Not A Lincoln, but A blank.
A blank. All right.
I like that.
Okay.
Well.
Now, is that all right? I suppose that
yes,
is.
All right.
Well.
Perfectly all right.
Perfectly respectful.
Yeah, this is very inside. You
okay.
Understand.
Esther is ready, so we come to Kim. The football coach. Oh, I beg your pardon. Come to Laura.
Right.
One to tie, two to win. The football coach said, I don't think my team is all that interested in football. In the middle of the huddle, they were passing around a...
Playboy magazine.
Playboy magazine. That would be an interesting picture.
Yeah.
But the celebrities look a little stunned at your answer, Laura.
Yeah.
And maybe we'll find out a reason for that.
We couldn't go back to Rubber Ducky, could we?
No.
No.
What did you say?
No,
she says Playboy magazine.
No, I have a toque.
A toque?
Yeah, so that's very, you have to understand that.
What in heaven's name is a toque?
Would you like to explain that?
As soon as Brett gives you her answer.
All right.
Cigarette.
Oh, it's a cigarette. Oh, all right. Brett.
Oh, what an odd choice of words. Playboy magazine's a terrific answer, sweetheart. If I'd thought of it, I would have said it. And heaven knows they're all over my house for my children and all that stuff, although I myself disapprove of them. I said joint.
I see. Okay. Charles?
Yes.
In a way, I don't know, man. In a way. Well, you know, sometime when you're a little woo, you come up with the right answer.
Oh! That was funny. Esther, It's up to
what?
You. If you do not match this lady's answer, or she does not match you, the game ends in a tie. If you do match, she wins. What do you say?
Oh, relief, relief. At least a tie. I said cigarette.
A cigarette. So we've got a tie here, and we've got to go to a tiebreaker. But first, before we do that, we've got to go to this. Tie. Wipe it clean. Tiebreaker. One for each. The one who matches the most will be the winner. Kim.
Be again, please.
Be again. Tiebreaker. Dumb Dora was so dumb. I tell you, she went to a Chinese hand laundry to have her blank washed. That's how dumb Dumb Dora was.
As soon as she went to a Chinese hand laundry.
She went to a Chinese hand laundry to have her blank washed.
Of course she did.
Chinese hand.
Of course she did.
No.
Oh dear.
Oh, I think that's marvelous. Went to a Chinese hand laundry.
Yes.
To have her blank washed.
Well, let's put it this way, it's not bad.
Oh, I think there's one perfectly terrific answer. Maybe two terrific answers. Yes. Okay, everybody ready up here?
Or several.
Now we come to Kim. Dumb Dora was so dumb, Kim.
Uh-huh.
Would you like to know how dumb she was?
How dumb was she?
She went to a Chinese hand laundry to have her blank washed.
Her hair washed.
Her hair. She would go to a hand laundry to have her hair washed?
Oh, that's pretty dumb, isn't it?
That's it.
Kim was so dumb.
She said...
Kim?
Yeah.
Let's just say that Dora called and said hi.
Yes?
If Dora played, she'd say cow at every answer.
Right. What'd you say, Joe?
She went to a Chinese hair laundry to have her hands washed.
I see.
What? Why didn't you think of that?
Why didn't you think
know,
of that?
I'm so dumb, right?
Yes.
It's
Brett?
It's hard when you're up there.
Yes, it is hard.
It's not Brett. Easy up here.
Hello, Brett.
Hi. Are we ready for me?
Yes, we are.
I was looking at Kim. She's such a pretty girl, and I love her voice, and she's darling. And if I said hair, and it would be like me to say hair.
Yes,
it would. But I didn't. I said her little hands, her fingers.
Hands or fingers. Charles.
Don't always look at her and think she's lovely. You're lovely. You have the same body. Just give it back. You're wrinkling it.
What? All right, Kim is looking for the answer. Hair. She went to a Chinese hand laundry to have her hair washed. Esther, you're up.
Well, I thought she'd go there to wash her doggy.
Wash her dog.
Esther!
That's interesting.
You go and sit with Kim.
Yes.
She's dumb. She's
yes.
All right.
Now, Richard.
Yes.
Went to a Chinese hand laundry to have her hair washed.
Hair.
Your hand wash. And Fanny.
This girl, I started to say hair. I couldn't think of anything, and I said chopsticks.
Her chopsticks.
Which is wrong.
Okay.
Sorry.
Now, what do you need here, Laurie? You need one to win the game. At the hospital, they made a big mistake. After the operation, they took Mr. Brown's appendix back to his room, and they stuck Mr. Brown in a blank.
You went so fast, my
It's a big mistake in the hospital.
Oh.
They took Mr. Brown's appendix back to his room, right. And they took stuck Mr. Brown in a blank.
Oh, got it.
Why?
Why?
Okay.
Why, Charles, it's finished.
Quickly.
Quickly.
All right, Laura. At the hospital, they made a big mistake. After the operation, they took Mr. Brown's appendix back to his room, and they stuck Mr. Brown in a...
Bottle.
Okay, Joe, show.
Okay, yes, indeed. Laura and I agree on a bottle.
Bottle wins the game. Like the rest of you. Okay. Here we go again. Now, Kim, may we wish you the best of luck in your theatrical endeavors. And it was a pleasure meeting you. We've got gifts for Kim Ackles. Goodbye, Kim. While we're spinning it off, here we go with this message for you. You were all splendid.
Oh, thank you.
Is that in?
Oh.
No, I mean it. You were really terrific. And
Yippee.
You're going to do it again mañana or whenever. So this is Gene Rayburn for Match Game 75, inviting you to join us next time. Goodbye.